Rosate pacalandera, Rakedo Zacapante catobagadante, Lica de Bagadagado Mendona, Rakado Zacatala Bagadante, Icatabacato Lacanto Labadia, Mesecate Begado Lacadanta, Icatabacatacado Zacatala Badante, Icatabacatacado Sapa Candalaria, Radadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadad
And I know that thou art with me, will be with me to the end. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I've proved him for and all. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust him, how I've proved him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him more.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We receive the grace to trust you more and more. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Let's put our hands together and dance to the Lord and give him worthy praise. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Lift him high. Lift him high. Lift up Jesus high. Oh, lift him high. He is worthy of praise.
Lift him high, lift him high, lift up Jesus high. Oh, lift him high, he is worthy of praise.
Lift him high, lift him high, lift up Jesus high. Oh, lift him high, he is worthy of praise.
Lift him high, lift him high, lift up Jesus high. Oh, lift him high, he is worthy of praise.
Yo
Praise you, Lord.
I will praise my God.
I will praise you, Lord. Everybody praise you, Lord.
I will praise you, Lord.
Everybody praise you, Lord.
I will praise you, Lord.
Everybody praise you, Lord.
I will praise you, Lord.
What shall I render? What shall I render? What shall I render to you, oh Lord? I will exalt your name and shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, oh? What shall I render? Render,
what shall I render?
Render, what shall I render to you, oh Lord? I will exalt your name and shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, oh Lord?
What shall I render?
What shall I render?
Render,
what shall I render?
Render, what shall I render to you, oh Lord?
I will exalt your name and shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, O Lord? I render praises, I render worship, I render honor to you, my God. I will exalt your name and shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, O Lord?
What shall I render?
What shall I render?
What shall I render?
What shall I render to you, O Lord?
I will exalt your name and shout hallelujah. What shall I render to you, O Lord?
To you, Lord,
I am the glory.
To you, my maker,
I am the honor.
To you, my provider,
I am the glory.
And adoration forevermore.
Oh yes, to you, Lord,
I am the glory.
To you,
ancient of days,
I am the honor.
To you, my provider,
I am the glory.
Adoration forevermore.
We are the glory.
To you, Lord.
We are the honor.
To you, Lord.
We are the glory.
And adoration forevermore.
To you, Lord.
We are the glory.
To you, Lord.
We are the honor.
To you, Lord.
We are the glory.
And adoration forevermore.
To you, Lord,
we are the glory.
To you, Lord,
we are the honor.
To you, Lord,
we are the glory.
And adoration forevermore.
To you, Lord,
we are the glory.
To you, Lord,
we are the honor.
Lord, we give you praise. Lift your voice and just exalt him and magnify him. Worship him, give him all the glory that is due his name. He's worthy of all our praise. Lift your voice, exalt him, magnify him. Tell him, Father, I love you. Father, I thank you. Thank you for my life. Thank you for everyone that you have put round and about me. The Bible told me you are the one who set up the solitary in family. I give you praise. Lift your voice. Thank him for everyone round and about you, that he did not allow the dead to be those around about you. It is the living that you are living with. Lift your voice and give him glory. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you all the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, we bow before your throne. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, we bow before your throne, bow before your throne.
Worship at your feet, bow before your throne. You are the glorious God, bow before your throne. Worship at your feet, bow before your throne. You are the glorious God.
Your name is Alpha
Together again, both online and live, to hear your word on growth in stature. Thank you, because this is your will concerning us. Be exalted, O God, in the name of Jesus. Today is the third day of this holy convocation. We ask, O God, that you bless us with your word again. Touch our lives and let us not remain the way we came to this service. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you. Welcome all those who have joined us online. God bless you. You may be seated. You can share the video with someone. You can share the video with someone so that they are blessed also. So they are blessed also. Hallelujah. Praise God. All right. You are welcome to God's presence. The word of God will be coming to us, and we shall be blessed. I'll be teaching on growth in stature, but today I'll be focusing on vertical growth and horizontal growth. Vertical growth and horizontal growth. Every growth in stature must be both ways, vertically and horizontally, or else you will not have a balance. If you are growing vertically only, you will be too thin to stand. Wind can break you. If you are going horizontally only, you'll be too wide. Be too wide. And then you'll be abnormal. So growth in stature must be vertical and horizontal. Must be vertical and horizontal. Acts chapter 19, verse number 20. You must grow vertically and horizontally. I'm coming. Acts of the Apostle, chapter number 19, verse 20. The Bible says, so mightily grew the word of God and prevailed. Mightily grew the word of God. That's growth in stature. Growth that makes you mighty is growth in stature. Growth that makes you mighty is growth in stature. Exodus chapter 1 verse 7. Exodus chapter number 1 verse 7. The Bible says, and the children of Israel were fruitful and increased abundantly and multiplied and waxed exceeding mighty, and the land was filled with them. That is growth in stature. They became very fruitful. They increased abundantly, 2. They multiplied, 3. They waxed exceeding mighty, 4. And the land was filled with them, 5. That is a sign to show that they grew in stature. They grew both vertically and horizontally. In Acts chapter 7, verse 17, Acts of the Apostles chapter number 7, verse number 17, the Bible says, but when the time of the promise drew near, which God had sworn to Abraham, the people grew and multiplied. The people grew and multiplied. Vertical growth and horizontal growth. They grew and also multiplied. So every kind of growth that is physical must either be vertical or horizontal. I began to emphasize on growth throughout this year, talking about growth, because this is our year of multidimensional growth. That's why you see me talking on different aspects of growth. I began to talk about growth seriously. Numbers chapter 13, verse 32 to 33. Numbers 13, 32 to 33. The Bible says, and they brought up an evil report of the land which they have searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. And all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. Growth in stature. They were of great stature. And there we saw the sons of Anak, which came of the giants. And we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so were we in their sight. I began to tell you that growth in stature intimidates your enemy. Men looking at you, they are intimidated straight. Growth intimidates. There are people that will swear never to be your enemy again when they see you growing. They change their mind from being your enemy as soon as they see you growing. When they sense growth, when they see you becoming bigger than you used to be when they knew you, they resign from being your enemies. The Bible says, this people said they were like grasshoppers. They reduced themselves in their own eyes and declared themselves grasshoppers. Hallelujah. Because they saw them with great stature. You must grow in life. You can't afford to be small. Everything you do must grow. If it doesn't grow, you will not command respect. There are some enemies that will come and overrun you. But when you start growing, they will respect you. They will fear you. Just mere seeing you, they will advise themselves not to attack you. There are some insults that will run away from you. Just mere seeing your size. Let me tell you a very humorous story. You know, that's a very humorous story of a certain person who wanted to use the toilet. In those days, pit latrine was the famous toilet. So this person wanted to use the toilet. By the time he ran to the toilet, another person was already inside that toilet. And he knocked the toilet and the guy said, I'm here. He said, please be fast before I download. Outside, and the guy in the toilet refused to come out early. So the man outside began to insult him and say, you must come out very fast. You want me to download in my body? My friend, be very fast. You've been there for a long time. And the person inside refused to come out. And he started insulting him. And said, if you come out, I will slap you. In fact, I will give you 4 slaps. You're a wicked man. You are a major mumu, and so on and so forth. We're just firing him. Say, well, just come out. Except you won't come out today. As soon as you come out, get ready for slap. So the man inside stayed. When he finished, he finally opened the door. When he came out, he was like 4 times the height of the man that wanted to slap him. The person that wanted to slap him couldn't even remember the slap. When he saw his height and his size, he advised himself to forget about the slap and go and sort himself out inside. What made him, in fact, he was even afraid that for insulting the man, he would get some beating. When he saw the height and the stature of the man that was inside that he was insulting, he forgot the insult and forgot his plan. His plan disappeared. See, stature, being big financially, being big spiritually, being big materially, being big physically, has a major role to play on earth. And that is why God made some angels to be very tall and very high, toweringly tall. You look up to them, you don't look down on them, sir. You only look down on people that you are taller than. When somebody is taller than you academically, you look up to him. When somebody is taller than you spiritually, you look up to him. When somebody is taller than you materially, you look up to him. Hallelujah, praise God. You know, somebody was teaching me music. And I told him, oh God, that is your area. That is the area you know. But because he delved into my area, he said, stop there. That one is my area. I teach you that one. He said, okay, sir, I surrender. That's the truth. Because you look up to somebody who knows more than you in an area. Because he had grown in stature in that area. Hallelujah, praise God. The Bible says they were like grasshoppers when they looked up at the stature of the giants. In 2 Samuel 21 verse number 20, the Bible says, and there was yet a battle in Gath, where was a man of great stature, and he had on every hand 6 fingers, and on every foot 6 toes, 24 in number, and he also was born of the giants. As in the size of the guy made God give him 6 fingers, not 5. 6, so that the guy can balance well on the ground. That's why I told you that you must grow vertically and horizontally. Because if you grow vertically alone and you don't grow horizontally, you can break. When one serious wind blow, they will discover that your backbone have removed. Because you are just long. You are not tall, you are long. If you also grow like this and you don't grow, you'll be like a pygmy. You'll be abnormal, awkward. If you are growing fat this way and you're not growing, no increase in height at all, you will not be looking good. In 1 Chronicles 11 verse 23, the Bible says, and he slew an Egyptian, a man of great stature, 5 cubits high, and in the Egyptian's hand was a spear like a weaver beam. And he went down to him with a staff and plucked the spear out of the Egyptian's hand and slew him with his own spear. Hallelujah. This was one of the warriors of David. The Bible says he had a stick in his hand. He used a stick to collect a spear. And the spear was like a weaver beam. Very heavy spear. And the man that he collected from was very big. So when you are big in stature, you need to load yourself well. Now let me now describe biologically. I want to go biological today on factors that determine vertical and horizontal growth. Factors that determines vertical and horizontal growth. I want to go biological. Number one, and I will apply it spiritually. Number one is nutrition. If you want to grow tall and grow fat, check what you eat. Inappropriate quantity of food and inappropriate quality of food can affect your growth. You did not hear me, I repeat. Inappropriate or food that is not according to size. For example, I am thinking that the reason why I'm smallish is because of the food I ate when I was small. because I didn't eat well. Now I'm telling you, nobody, I'm saying the truth, my. I didn't eat well. There were times I was so hungry. I was so hungry until, you know, there's a kind of hunger that will wire you until you are no more hungry again. When you are so hungry and there's nothing to eat, you swallow saliva, swallow wind, drink water, and your stomach is doing kolom, 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 kolom. No, some of you came from rich family. You did not understand what I'm talking about. You will so drink water that your stomach will be so full of water that the water will start giving you stress. There's nothing else to eat. It happened to me not once, severally, until my body got used to no food. After a while, I started having access to beans. I began to tell you guys that if beans make people tall, I should be the tallest in the world because I ate beans until I hated beans. I'm telling you, sir. Presently, when my wife cooks beans, I don't even like it. She's forcing me to eat it. She's putting fish, putting egg, putting plantain, putting all kinds of so that I can be enticed to eat it. She will tell me it is good for your body. She's preaching to me the gospel according to St. Beans. And, and I'm looking at her. The reason is that I was punished by beans. I was punished by it. I was eating it alone, sometimes only with Gary. So I was malnourished. I didn't take the right food. So not taking the appropriate quantity, one. Not taking the appropriate quality, two. Number three, inability to absorb. There are some times when I eat some food and they tell me they are very good, like vegetable. As it enters my body and turns it, everything will come out, including the good, the bad, and the ugly. Everything comes out. I will go to the toilet and down. Inability to absorb the food can make you not to grow. And also excessive losses. When you are dehydrated very fast and you download very fast, you poo-poo very fast, you urinate very, they will not settle in your body. You will not be fat. You will not grow tall and you will not grow fat. Vertical growth will be hindered. Horizontal growth will also be hindered when you have these problems. Inappropriate quantity of food, inappropriate quality of food, inability to absorb the food, and excessive loss of food from your body. So also, let's apply it directly spiritually. For you to grow in stature spiritually, you need appropriate quantity and quality of God's word. You need ability to absorb that word. You drink in the word, you act the word, and then don't lose the word fast. When you always lose the word of God from your memory very fast, you'll never be a man of a great stature in spiritually. No, you'll never be. You always be thin in the spirit. Very small in the spirit. Number two, the second biological factor that determines whether a man grows vertically high and horizontally wide is genetics. Genetics. The genes in your body, the genes that came from your father and mother that entered into you, the genes. Genetics is determined by your family stature. If there are many short guys in your family, by the grace of God, you'll be short. Constitutional delay of growth. There are some factors that can constitute delay in your growth. If those factors remain, you'll be smallish. Syndromes, genetic abnormalities can stop you from growing. So also spiritually, if you came from a church where they believe in a certain thing and they don't believe in others, you will never grow in the area that they don't believe in. For example, if you don't believe in prosperity, or you attend a church that doesn't believe in prosperity, you will be very poor. You'll be anointedly poor. Or you go to a church where they don't pray well, you will be a talkative without prayers. Or if you go to a church where they are excessively pray, you'll be a prayer machine. So also, if you belong to a family where they are short, you'll be short. You will inherit shortness. So genetic abnormalities, what you inherit, can affect you. For example, one of the fastest things you should know when somebody has stayed in World Changers for a while is boldness. That one is in our gene here. If you see a world changer that is not bold, it's either he's committing sin, or maybe he's an agent of the devil. It's difficult to say, watching that, a member of this church that is not bold. It's very difficult. Because that's the first thing they get when they get here, because their pastor is very bold. Number two, prayer. It's difficult to find a member of the church that's not a prayer white machine. Whether the one that doesn't like prayer and the one that likes prayer, they pray by force. Because prayer is compulsory here. Number three, it is difficult to find a watch here that doesn't understand the word of God widely, not just word only. They understand the rhematic version and the logos version. They understand it widely because their pastor teaches widely. I don't just teach narrow teaching. No way. So when you see a world changer talking, he's talking as an intellectual, not somebody who is narrow-minded. Hallelujah. Praise God. So genetic constitution affects your growth, both spiritually and biologically. Number three, endocrine status. Endocrine status. I'm going biological today, so you know. Endocrine status. This talks about the hormones in your body. The hormones in your body and the ones that is deficient can determine whether you grow tall or short, whether you grow fat or thin. Growth hormone deficiency can make you not to grow. You'll just be thin permanently. No matter what they give you to eat, you'll be thin, fat. The hormone that you have will be eating the thing and be removing it from your body. When you have thyroid problems, when there is early and late puberty, when you have adrenaline problems, those are hormones. Hypothalamus problems, your brain problem, when it cannot coordinate, when such problems are inside the body, then you are not able to grow. Now, let me apply it spiritually. When there are things you don't believe in, it will affect your growth. So you must believe that you will grow and then begin to grow. See, whatever you see around me is what I believe. Very soon you see crowd in this church in a way you've never seen them before, because I believe it. So endocrine status is talking about the hormones in your body. In the spirit realm, hormones come by faith. What you believe becomes your hormone. Number four, the fourth determinant of vertical and horizontal growth is bone health. The health of your bone. When your bone is not healthy, you will not, can never be a soldier, because they know if there's need to run, you can't run. You can't run. If there's need to climb something very fast, because of the shape of your bone, your leg will hook the wood. They'll catch you there. You will disgrace the army. So they will not take you. In fact, my father told us that when you are going to be a soldier, they'll tell you to put your leg flat on the floor and they'll check whether that hole, there's a part of your leg that needs to have space like this. If it's not there, you're not going to be admitted to being an army officer. You will never be a soldier. So she said she does all that to make us balanced. And all my sisters grew up well. All of us grew up well. But she died when I was 8 years old. So if she was around, I think I would have been taller than this. I think so. But I'm happy. I'm fine. Hallelujah. Praise God. I don't like being like Zacchaeus, you know. That I have to be climbing tree to see Jesus. I want to see Jesus directly. Because when you are like Zacchaeus, it's very dangerous. When you are standing below everybody, when they download it, you'll be the one that will collect all the space because of your height. So I don't want to be like that, because I love being tall. Praise God. Hallelujah. So your bone health determines whether you grow tall or not, or whether you grow fat. When you have fat bones, you start growing fat. When you have bones that are long, you start growing tall. But when your bone does not have those things, see, it is the mineral content in your bones that determines whether you grow tall or short. Or when your bones also have abnormal structure, it can affect your height and your size. Number five, psychosocial environment. Your environment can affect your growth. Psychosocial environment. Your environment can affect your growth. It cannot be himself and herself. Those kind of things can affect growth. It can affect it. When the family and the home environment is not conducive, it can affect your growth. Number six, chronic diseases can affect growth. Chronic diseases can be inherited if you grow in lust and seduction. So the atmosphere you build around yourself determines how you grow spiritually. If you want to be a good teacher, like for example, when I wanted to be a great teacher of God's word, God told me to start listening to teachers like Reverend George Adeboye. That man is a teacher. Dr. Frederick K.C. Price. That guy is a teacher. Those are teachers that affected my life. I mean, people, Reverend Joe Olaya, those are people that are tearers of the word with revelation. So when I listened to them, the grace came on me. That atmosphere came. People like Billy Akane, that one is a child. Pastor Adeboye calls him teacher of teachers. He will teach you, your head will be very correct. Hallelujah. So the atmosphere you create around yourself determines how you grow. When I wanted to prosper financially, I got teachings of Bishop David Oyedepo. It affected me financially and made me understand how to grow financially. Are you understanding me? When I needed to grow in prayer, Dr. D.K. Olukoya taught me. Oh, in fact, I play some of his tapes sometimes and I leave it to play overnight. Every demon sitting over my life, what are you doing there? Die, die, die. You will pray by force. So the atmosphere, psychosocial atmosphere that you put around yourself determines your spiritual growth, so also physically. All right, chronic diseases. When you have wrong things in the atmosphere spiritually, it can affect your growth, so also biologically. Like I told you, there are some that people get, you know, transferred by blood or by gene or by inheritance. But there are some that you acquire because of bad lifestyle or accidental lifestyle. Such things affect your growth, like cardiovascular diseases. This is disease that has to do with your heart. It limits the pumping of the blood and affects your heart region, and it can limit your growth. Pulmonary diseases. Diseases that affect your breathing system, and you can't breathe well anymore. It will affect your growth. Infections. Hematological diseases. Diseases that have to do with blood. It can affect your growth. Renal diseases and neuro diseases. All those diseases can affect. Followed before. Used to do all those gra-gra. You know, like maybe when people drop offering, he collects his own before he writes the remaining for the church. That is a thief. So, well, he said his mentor does those kind of things. You know, plays games, pretends, and those kind of things. So, when you mix with such persons, they can affect your growth spiritually to the extent that you will not be a thief, but you are a Christian. If you mix up with people who are fornicators, as you are growing spiritually, you will be a Christian but a fornicator. Later, an adulterer or an adulteress. Like that. So, such diseases affect and infect your life. Number seven. The seventh one is now the final height and stature of that Christian. So, let us look back at the biological factors. Number one, nutrition. Number two, genetics. Number three, endocrine status. Number four, bone health. Number five, psychosocial environment. Number six, chronic diseases. Number seven is final height. Your final height can be very short. It can be short. It can be tall. It can be very tall. And then it could be towering height. It can also be short and fat. It can be very short and fat. It cannot be tall and huge. And very tall and huge. And towering and also huge. May God give us the positive one in the name of Jesus Christ. See, it is good to grow and be big. It gives you rest. It balances up some areas of your life and makes you solid. Now listen carefully. Growth brings establishment in life. I repeat, growth makes you to be established. When you have not grown, they can remove you. And he told me one day that God told him to go and start a ministry. So I blessed him, gave him some money, and released him to go and start the ministry. And he went, started the ministry. I remember I flew to the country where he was, and I blessed him and blessed his ministry, and I came back. After a while, he called me and said he wants to close the ministry. Are you okay? When I critically interviewed him and checked what was wrong with him, he said they have not grown more than 5 or 10 for 6 months. So that affected his morale, and his morale went low, and he closed the ministry. Lack of growth discouraged him. So I fired him and asked him, do you know how I began and how other ministries begin? Many times they remain small for a while, then suddenly they shoot up. That's the way God works. The Bible says, it is like a seed of the mustard seed. It is planted in the earth. For a long time, other trees will be taller than it. But suddenly when it starts growing, whoop, it grows taller than all trees, taller than all shrubs. He started his ministry with 3,000 members. 3,000 members. Because that other pastor's church is 20,000 members. The pastor announced and said, pastor, this and that person is leaving to go and start his ministry. He's a son indeed. I am pleased with him. Therefore, any one of you that wish to follow him, you can follow him. 3,000 people just left the church and followed him. And the pastor is happy. His senior pastor is also happy. Now, that is his level of operation. That is where God had placed him. Now, there are some of us that started with one person clapping with us. No keyboard. I remember in those days when World Changers started in Nairobi, when I give offering, after the service, the lady, the only one lady that came to church will collect the offering back as a transport. Then I won't be able to go home. I will now stay. Then I will flash one of my friends who will come and pick me and go home. Everybody have their level. You cannot compare yourself to that guy who started. You do not know how he has started ministry over the years and served under that man of God that declared and said, if you want to follow him. And 3,000 people followed him. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, you need to ask God for your own pattern now. Deuteronomy chapter 33 verse 6. Deuteronomy 33 verse 6 says, let Reuben live and not die. Let not his men be few. Death is one of the things that limits growth. And then curses limit growth also. Do more things that will make people bless you than that will make people curse you. Reuben was cursed by his father when he went to sleep with his father's concubine. And that curse limited his growth in life until Moses came and blessed him and changed the curse into a blessing and said, let Reuben live and not die, because people were dying in Reuben's family. And he said, let not his men be few. Do you know Reuben lost his firstborn sheep because his men were dying and it was few? He could not be the firstborn. God had to transfer the firstborn to Joseph, but permanently to Judah. Judah became the firstborn. And Judah was number three. He was junior to Reuben. Why? Because of this. In Numbers 26 verse 54, the Bible said, to many thou shalt give the more inheritance, and to few thou shalt give the less inheritance. To everyone shall his inheritance be given according to those that were numbered of him. Inheritance is given to people according to their stature. If you want to have a great inheritance on earth from God, grow. Full stop. Grow. If you don't grow, you'll never have inheritance. Growth determines the inheritance you are given. I see it again in Numbers 33. Verse 53 to 54. The Bible says, and ye shall dispossess the inhabitants of the land and dwell therein. There are people that were already in the land. Say, you will chase them away and take the land. For I have given you the land to possess it. That was why you saw the day we stood there and, you know, the papers were handed over to me and we've already paid for the land. I dispossessed the man that was here at the land. I said, Oga, leave immediately, leave. He said, no. I said, Oga, the way you are seeing all this maze, they will soon be lying flat on the floor in 1 hour. He thought I was joking. So I called the foreman. Foreman, get me some men to make all this corn to lie flat on the floor, because from this second henceforth, this is not a farm anymore, it's a church. You dispossess. See, when you have a stronger vision, you dispossess those who have a weaker vision. So grow your vision. When your vision is small, another person's vision will come and swallow your own. You did not hear me, I repeat. Grow your vision to be mighty. When your vision is small, another person's vision will come and swallow your vision. The vision of the man was to make this place a farm, but my vision was to make it a church. So I bought it over and removed the farm, swallowed up the vision, and put the vision of God here, and the vision began to flourish. Hallelujah, praise God. You know, somebody saw the corn here in picture and said, if that place is that fertile, that place will be fertile for ministry. And that is the truth. It's very fertile for ministry in Jesus' name. Now, verse number 54, the Bible says, and ye shall divide the land by lot for an inheritance among your families, and to the more ye shall give the more inheritance, and to the fewer ye shall give the less inheritance. Every man's inheritance shall be in the place where his lot falleth, according to the tribe of your fathers ye shall inherit. To the more you give more. When you grow in stature, God gives you more blessings. But when you remain small, God gives you small blessings. Grow up. Grow in stature. Be strong spiritually. Grow up. You see, prayers going on every day. Children will not join that prayer. Only those who have grown will join that prayers. Maturity. One of the signs to know that you are mature is when you are consistent. When you are not consistent, especially spiritually, you are not mature. You don't merit plenty things. God cannot trust you. So he gives you small, small things. Small, small granite and biscuit. Because when God gives you plenty things, you will squander it. You are not mature. So when you are consistent in serving God, God knows that you are mature enough to handle big things. But when they need to push you before you come to God's presence, you don't qualify for big things. They need to provoke you, fire you, insult you, abuse you before you now say, okay, I'll try. You are making yourself a scarce commodity in God's presence. You don't qualify for progress. But when you come to God's presence on your own and you make every other thing revolve around God's presence, then you are mature, qualified enough to get bigger inheritance. You are the one that pulls people to, not that some little thing can take you out of God's presence. Every other thing must revolve around you being in God's presence. If you want to see me now, tell you, come to church and see me. I'm in the church. I cannot leave any service for anybody. No way. I go to where? That's what happened. That who died. That is now Jesus. Many times when you run after men, you remain under men for the rest of your life. If a man can take you out of God's presence anytime, that man is greater than God in your life permanently. You are a fool. You're a foolish person. That man is greater than God in your life. Anybody that can take you out of God's presence, as we are here now having this meeting, I'm preaching the word of God to you, and somebody is powerful enough to take you out of God's presence, aye, that person is stronger than God in your life. That is the truth. So for you to grow and have more, stick to God, be consistent and committed so that God can give you more. The more you stay, the more you have. The less you stay, the less you have. So grow. Whoever is more will get more inheritance. Whoever is less will get less inheritance. Numbers 35 verse number 8 spoke along that line again. It says in Numbers 35 verse 8, and the cities which ye shall give shall be of the possession of the children of Israel. From them that have many, ye shall give many. But from them that have few, ye shall give few. Everyone shall give of his cities unto the Levites according to his inheritance which he inherited. If you want your destiny to be like a city destiny, you need to develop yourself more. Crowd attracts crowd. Big numbers attract bigger numbers. Small numbers attract small numbers. That is it in the Bible here. Hallelujah, praise God. So how do I activate growth in stature? I'll give you five keys and I'll close. Number one, how do I activate growth in stature in all areas of life? Number one, believe that growth in stature is possible. Believe it. Believe that growth in stature is possible. Because in life, whatever you believe is what you become. In this life, whatever you believe is what you become. What you don't believe, you can never become it. What you believe is what you become. It has always been unto men according to what they believe. So be it unto you according to your faith. be it unto you according to your faith. It has always been unto men according to their faith. It is what you believe you become. Whatever you have become today is the product of what you believed. Change your belief and then you change what you will become. You don't change your belief, you remain the way you are. Hallelujah, praise God. Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. Genesis 1:28. And God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. God blessed them and said, be fruitful. Believe this word of God. Be fruitful. Believe it. You will grow in stature. You will multiply. You will replenish the earth. In Isaiah 27 verse number 6, Isaiah 27 says, he shall cause them that come out of Jacob to take root. Israel shall blossom and bud and fill the face of the world with fruits. You will grow in stature and be big, and you fill up everywhere. Your business will flourish and fill up every nation. That is why you see me. I believe it. That's why I see the flag of all nations is here. I believe it. I'll fill the whole world with fruit. This one. That's what. It's not today. It's been there from day one. Because I believe it. Numbers chapter 14 verse 21. Numbers 14 21 says, but as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of God. So believe that God will fill the earth because of you. You will not be small in the name of Jesus. So believe it. Number two, pray for growth in all its ramifications. Pray for growth. Because growth is supernatural. The Bible says, Paul plants, Apollo waters, but God gives the increase. Increase comes from God. Growth is supernatural. So pray for growth in all its ramifications. Look at the Bible. Genesis 24 verse 1. The Bible says, and Abraham was old and well stricken in age, and the Lord had blessed Abraham in all things. He grew in every area. God had blessed Abraham in all things. You can grow in stature in every area. So don't think there's an area you should not grow. God has blessed you in this area, you cannot grow in this area. It's a lie. So you can grow in stature in all areas. Number three, ask God for what to do in order to grow in stature. Because your own instruction could be peculiar to you. Ask God for what to do in order to grow in stature. Pray and say, Father, what should I do so I can grow? God will tell you what to do. Ask God. Isaiah chapter number 30 verse 21. Isaiah chapter 30 verse 21, the Bible says, and thine ears shall hear a word behind thee, telling thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, when ye turn to the right hand, and when ye turn to the left. Your ears will be open. A word will come. God will speak to you and tell you, this is the way to growth. Walk ye in it. Everybody have their own path. So if you are copying somebody, it may not be your path. So ask God to show you your pathway to growth. Number four, start praising God for growth in stature daily. Start praising God for growth in stature financially, growth in stature spiritually, growth in stature materially, growth in stature in your business. Start thanking God for it. Start praising God for growth in stature daily. The Bible says in Acts chapter 2, verse 47. Acts 2:47 says, praising God and having favor with all people. When you praise God and you have favor with all people, it says, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. When you praise God, God will add growth to you. When you praise God, God will add growth to you. Praising God and the Lord added. Praising God and the Lord added. Praising God and the Lord added. When you praise God for growth, God will add growth to you. When you shut up, you remain where you are. Praising God. Let me show you again. Jeremiah chapter 30 verse number 19. Jeremiah chapter number 30 verse 19 says, And out of them shall proceed thanksgiving and the voice of them that are happy, people that are merry. So when they begin to get happy and they start thanking me, says, and I will multiply them and they shall not be few, and I will glorify them and they shall not be small. Why? Because they are thanking me. So start thanking God. In fact, whenever we start service, rush in for praise and worship. Don't joke with it. And whenever they are doing praise and worship, don't sit down. I'll be checking Moses and say, ah, this guy is very slim. Oh, very slim guy. Praise God. And you're waiting for me to come and preach. No, stop it. Stand and dance. Worship God and give him praise. Worship God and give him praise. And then the Almighty God will bless you and cause it to be well with you. Are you understanding me? He will multiply you, like he said. He said he will multiply you and you will not be small. He will multiply you and you will not be few. In the name of Jesus Christ. Number five. The fifth point, as I wind up this night, on growth in stature, vertically and horizontally. Take the required nutrition daily if you want to grow. Take the required nutrition, not weekly. How? Daily. If you eat intermittently, by the grace of God, you will not grow. You will grow kwashokoli. You will grow abnormally. You must take the required nutrition daily. You must take the required nutrition and exercise. There was a bodily exercise profited little. You must take the required nutrition daily. If you do not take the required nutrition daily, you cannot grow. You cannot grow in stature. You cannot grow. Spiritually, there are required nutrition. The three most important things you need to do every day spiritually is word, worship, warfare. Three things. It is compulsory. WWW. Word. You must eat the word of God. Worship, you must sing and praise God. Warfare, you must pray. Those three are compulsory in your life every day if you want to grow. If you see all our flyers, you will see I write there word, worship, warfare. I sat down to check the entire Bible. What is required for me to be a giant? I discovered that globally, from before I was born until after I've left this world, it's word, worship, warfare. Those three are uncompromising. You must have them in your life. You must eat them daily. You must pray every day. You must learn to worship God every day. But I notice some people in Nairobi, they don't like worshiping God. They hide their face when they're worshiping God. They only listen to God's word and pray. Some people don't even like prayer. The three, and you need the three to mix together. It's like you want to eat ugali without soup. You will suffer. It will hook your throat. So you need some soup and some water to wash it down, to organize it well, so that you don't have constipation. When you are in the toilet, you are doing like, because there was no Sukuma Wiki. Oh, sorry, those of you online, you don't know what Sukuma Wiki is. Sukuma Wiki is Sukuma Wiki. There is a certain vegetable, we call it Sukuma Wiki in Kenya. When you eat it, it will organize your system. Hallelujah. You need a combination of word, worship, warfare every day to live a righteous life, to live a life stronger than your enemies, to withstand in the evil day. You need word, worship, warfare. Those three are compulsory. You must eat the right nutrition every day. Acts chapter 2, verse 46 to 47. Acts 2, 46 to 47. The Bible says, and they continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. Then the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. Take your nutritional requirement every day. They were eating meat daily in singleness of heart and gladness. They were breaking bread daily. They grew. They became strong and big in stature. Hebrews chapter number 5. verse 12 to 14. Hebrews chapter number 5, verse 12. What the Bible says, for when for the time ye ought to be teachers, ye have need that one teach you again, which be the first principles of the oracles of God, and have become such as have need of milk and not of strong meat. For everyone that useth milk is unskilled in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongeth to them that are full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. Eat strong meat. Listen to raw word of God. Not every time they're telling you, it shall be well with you. Ah, it's well with you. Somebody says well with me. Say amen. Well with me. Say well, 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 well. Say well, well, well. Praise God. And you go. Bros, when devil harass you, you will poo-poo before he beats you up. You need to hear raw word, hard word, word that will fortify you. You need to pray until you don't know how, what to pray again. Yes, pray to the level that you don't know what to pray about again. You have finished your prayer point. That's, you have prayed, sir. You need to serve God until you are not like a fanatic, until you are obsessed in serving God. You need to hear word that is hard, hard meat. Not where they are pampering you. Then the day they rebuke you, you are angry. You don't want to come to church again. Why are they talking to me like that? That you are who? Arrogance, pride. You need to get rid of it and settle down and hear the word of God. When they rebuke you, say, thank you for rebuking me, O Jere, so that I will not go to hellfire. Hallelujah. Praise God. One woman said she needed to talk to me. She fired me seriously. After firing me, I thanked her very much. And I told her I'm very grateful for the firing, because this one will prevent me from going to hell. She said, eh? Apostle, you said, yeah. Hi, thank you for the firing. She was amazed. All the gra-gra came down when I answered her politely. I'm very grateful. Thank you for the firing. At least this firing will help me not to go to hellfire. So be humble enough to receive the word of God. The Bible says you should eat strong meat. Strong meat. So you can be sound enough for where God is taking you to. Or else, if you grow like according to Ezekiel, they said that there is one called Kenyeji. And whatever, what do you call it? Broiler and Kenyeji. Broiler is chicken that you give fertilizer to fertilize and it became big. Kenyeji is the elderly chicken that grew up in the village. Am I correct? The one that you can't crack the bone when your teeth will hook somewhere. You will need to remove and humble yourself. Hallelujah. You better don't grow up and be a fertilizer broiler. In the spirit realm, when wind blows, it will take you away from the floor. But when you are strong, no devil can remove you. You become unoperable, steadfast. Hallelujah. So you need strong meat. Those chicken that they call Kenyeji, they eat strong meat. They pick millipede, pick rat, pick rabbit, pick everything and eat. But these other ones, the broilers, you give them sawdust like food. So they are just big, but they don't taste well, self. They don't taste well like Kenyeji, am I correct? And they don't taste like that. And then they may look big, bugu bugu, like that. We have fat meat, but it's the nutritional content is very low. But Kenyeji, when you eat that one, chai. So also when the Christian have eaten strong meat, you'll be very tasty and finger licking. You'll be all-roundedly strong. But when you love eating, you got to make it, man. Somebody say, make it. You got to make it. Say, yeah, give Jesus a wiper. You wipe Jesus' face as if you're in the wiper colonial party. And you wipe Jesus' face. Excuse me, sir. The day of calamity, when the devil say, hey, you will run. Your leg will be touching your neck as you take off. Why? Because you don't have stamina to withstand the devil. So take the required nutritional content daily, so that you can be strong and then you can grow to full stature in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe you have learned something this evening. I believe you have learned something this evening. If you have learned something, I want everyone online, write what you have learned. Let me hear. Write it. Send now. Go online. Start writing. What have you learned? Madam Simone Abala said, amen. I believe in supernatural growth in Jesus' name. Adebisi Funsho Adisa said, when you have a bigger vision, you will dispose of smaller vision. Glory to God. You're correct, man. Kelvin Nyaga said he's following. Lenuta Dragisi said she is following. Rita Ugumba said she's following. Grace Israel is watching with you. Hallelujah. Praise God. If you have learned something, send it. Let me read it from here. Send it quickly. What have you gained today to make you grow in stature? It is not the will of God for you to be small. God wants you to grow mightily, so mightily grew the word and prevailed. Acts chapter 19, verse 20. Acts of the Apostles chapter number 19, verse 20 says, and so might project it quickly. So mightily grew the word of God and prevailed. When you grow, you prevail. When you don't grow, you don't prevail. When you grow, you prevail. When you are small, they prevail over you. In fact, when you are small, you travail. But when you grow, you prevail. Travailing is different from prevailing. Travailing is when, like, a woman wants to give birth and she's in pain. Groaning for the baby to come out. That's travailing. Travailing is like suffering. Prevailing is overcoming. When you grow, you prevail. When you remain small, you travail in life. Make up your mind to grow big in business. Make up your mind to grow big in every aspect of life. There's nothing glorious in being small. There's nothing glorious in being tiny. There's nothing glorious in being tiny. So grow and become mighty. Even our God is called Almighty God, not all tiny God. God Almighty God, not all tiny God. So what are you doing with tiny things? So grow and become mighty. Hallelujah. Monica King said, growth in status must be both vertically and horizontally. Okay, growth in stature. Stature. S-T-A-T-U-R-E. Stature. Growth in stature. Growing in stature, as in not status. Okay, so growth in stature is to grow mightily. Yes, Pastor Grace said, praise activates favor and addition. Very correct. Moses Karuwanda said, daily dose include word, worship, warfare. You are correct. When you have the daily dose of word, worship, warfare, you will grow, sir. It is required daily. When you take it every day, you will grow. Every other person, please go ahead, send to me, what have you learned as we round off now? What have you learned today? Tomorrow I will enter another dimension. Today I came from the biological angle. Tomorrow I'll enter from another dimension. If you are there, please send. Let us see you writing what you have gained today. The Lord God Almighty will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. As you prepare to pray right now, I want us to pray, Father, grace to grow. Let it rest on me now. I want to grow vertically and horizontally. I don't want to be limited in life. Fire prayer wherever you are. Father, help me to grow vertically and horizontally. I want to grow in stature. In stature. I refuse to remain small. My destiny will not be small. I refuse to be small in destiny. Help me to grow in stature. Zuketeke bregedusha. Mazoko logo dogodogo bregedusha anda. Mabeketeke bregedusha gadusata. Oria kataka taka 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 taka. Iko logo dogo 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 dogo. Mareka taka bregedusha gadusa anda li kaduse. Roke lege dege dege dege. Ora kata 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 kata. Mareka dogo 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 dogo. Uzike lega dega dega brega do shiga do sakadanta. Maro kata 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 kata. Izo kologo dogo 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 dogo. Ora kata 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 brega do shiga do sakadanta. Maro kata lega dega 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 dega. E katoko brogo do shiga do segedente. Oria kataka braga dogo dogo dogo. Thank you, Father. I release the anointing for growth now. Growth in stature. Vertical and horizontal growth. Vertical and horizontal growth. Vertical and horizontal growth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Vertical and horizontal growth. Zekataka bragado shekaruza. I release that anointing now. I release the anointing right now for vertical and horizontal growth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, for vertical and horizontal growth, receive it right now. Zente de gebregado shegaduza, mare kataka bragado shegaduza kelente gebregaduza, oria kataka bragado shegaduza ta. Vertical and horizontal growth in every area of life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because your children believe that they will grow, let them grow now. Let the growth begin. Growth in this ministry begin. Numerical growth, spiritual growth, growth in maturity, growth in membership, growth in branches. Start now, global branches in every nation on earth. Let it start right now. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Wherever you are right now, it's time for us to give our offerings. So let us get our offerings and send it electronically through the pay bill number 821430. Wherever you are in any part of this nation, do that now. Or in East Africa, it's very easy. If you are outside Africa, you can use the Send Wave app and send it to the number there. It will come straight to the number. That's the way it works. And the Lord God Almighty will bless you. If you need the account of the church, it will be projected. You can take photograph of the account and send in your tithes, your seed, and your offering. I want every one of us to join the building of the church of God here. So join, send your seed so we can get some more material and roof this church and make the place fantastic for worship and for ministry. Hallelujah. Praise God. So go ahead. Do it now. I release the anointing upon every giver. I decree as you give, the hand of God will rest mightily upon you. You will never beg for anything good. The Almighty God will cause you to grow in stature financially in the name of Jesus Christ. You'll be better and better than you were before financially in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Go ahead, send in your offering. If you want to give physically, can we have the bowl here or something? Pastor Moses, can we have it here? If you want to give physically, you can move forward and drop yours physically. And the Lord God Almighty will receive, you know, your and release blessings on you in the name of Jesus Christ. He will bless you beyond measure. He will bless you mightily. You know, I do not want to be one of the pastors that say people should give and then I will not give. No. I want God to bless me mightily too. I know that God will bless me mightily too. So I have to do my own. Hallelujah. Praise God. Don't postpone your giving and say, I will give later. Ah, that's the beginning of poverty. You will postpone your prosperity. So give now and keep giving, and the blessing of the Lord that make it rich will follow you. Project the pay bill, please. Project the pay bill. All right. Please announce to someone that a conference like this is going on and we are talking about growth in stature. Announce to somebody, share the video. You can watch it over and over again. You can also teach somebody what I've taught you. And the Almighty God will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to close right now. I declare everybody who have watched blessed as the heaven remains and as the Lord liveth, you will grow and become mighty in the name of Jesus Christ. You will never be small. From now henceforth, the favor of God will decorate your destiny and it will be well with you. So shall it be. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Keep growing in stature in Jesus' name. Let's share the grace in fellowship. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever and ever. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.